Welcome to All Home Care Matters, the show where we discuss all things home care, with discussions on important age-related matters and topics. Brought to you by Enriched Life Home Care Services, the number one rated home care provider in Michigan by Top Rated Local.
Hello, and welcome back to All Home Care Matters. If this is your first time visiting us here at the show, we want to say thank you for taking time out to be with us today. We appreciate how valuable everyone's time is, and that's why we try and make each episode here at All Home Care Matters something that hopefully matters to you. Today, we are welcoming back Alexis Baker, board-certified music therapist from Bridgetown Music Therapy, who's here to share with us her new online music courses that they will be offering families. Welcome, Alexis.
Oh, thank you so much. It's great to be back with you.
Yeah, you're welcome. And, you know, I'm excited to have you back. I know you reached out and you're excited to share with us that you guys at Bridgetown Music Therapy have launched this really fascinating online music course for families and for people that are taking advantage of the music therapy that you're offering. Why don't you walk us through that? What is the online courses like and where they're able to access them at and how they have been doing so far?
Yeah, so I'm really excited to share about this because it's a fairly new program. We've been going for just under a year and we really launched it in response to COVID. So the whole idea is that it's kind of this on-demand, it's a subscription service. So all the videos live on our website in a member area. And when you sign up and become a member, you get access to them. And we upload a new video every week. So the content's always rotating and new. And it's like a 50 to 60 minute length video type class or session. And it involves a lot of singing. We have all the song lyrics on the videos as subtitles. And then we also include PDF download with each if you want to actually print out the song lyrics, and then guided movement, light stretching to music, and then we always end with deep breathing relaxation to music. So that's kind of the flow. And the idea is that it's on demand, so you can log on anytime and access them anytime. And we started providing this as an alternative to in-person sessions. Zoom even comes with its own challenges. So they are pre-recorded video classes.
And if I remember from the last time you were here, you were having to do some therapy over the phone even, right?
Yes, I tried all kinds of things.
For someone who's watching or listening to this, you say, you know, all of the courses are in a members only area on your website. If there's a person that has a particular genre of music or they have a specific need, maybe they've been recommended to take music therapy for a certain issue versus a different issue, is it broken up into categories or how is it structured?
Yeah, great question. So the way it's set up and designed is to appeal to a wide audience. So it's not any one particular type of music. We include all kinds of music that appeal to older generations. So, you know, folk songs, country western, big band, blues, rock and roll, like the early rock and roll, music that spans from like the early 1900s. Through the 70s, I would say it's a pretty wide range. But then about half of our video classes are themed sessions. So we might have a holiday theme and we launch it the week of that holiday. So it's appropriate for that time of year and can help with orientation to time of year and just celebrating that holiday. We also have just miscellaneous type of themes, like one of them is Hawaiian themed, one of them is all rock and roll music, or one of them is even like sun, moon, and stars, and we just took songs that included those themes. themes and put them all together in one type of class. And they're all labeled in the member area, so you can easily see them and choose what you'd like, or just go along with the ones we release week by week.
When people are hearing this or watching this, we get a lot of questions often when it deals with technology or things online. You know, is this going to be complicated? Is it hard? Is it very user friendly? And then also, is this something that can be accessed with a smartphone, or is this all through either a laptop or a PC? Or what kind of equipment do people need in order to be able to access these?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we try to keep it, as we were setting it up, we tried to keep it really simple. So it's just when you sign up, you get an account, and that's your own account, and you have a login. And so we do recommend that if they can be used individually in home or in care settings with a group or with individuals in that type of setting. But we do recommend that there's someone there, whether it's a caregiver, staff member, to help with that, the setup side of it. But it can be accessed from any smart device. So whether it is a phone, iPad, laptop, you can play it from those devices, or just like sync it with a smart TV and have it up on the TV. It's just a matter of signing in, choosing the video, gathering the participants or individual, and then hitting play.
Fun. I know my grandmother had dementia, and the music that most had a positive effect on her was gospel songs, and not so much the contemporary ones, but, you know, the old hymnals. And, you know, she became nonverbal towards the end, but you could always tell when, you know, she was listening to like Amazing Grace or How Great Thou Art or Old Rugged Cross, songs from, you know, her childhood. And a lot of them even before her childhood, you know, it really lifted her spirits. Do you have gospel songs and things like that on the site too?
Yeah, so we have three, a hymns part one, hymns part two, because we keep the video length to 50 to 60 minutes. So we just had enough content to do two. And then we have like a hymns and spirituals, which go back to like African American music, This Little Light of Mine, those type of songs that are called spirituals. So we have those few to choose from. And what's cool about our program is all previous classes are available. So we're really like creating a video class library that they can go back and pull from. And also we're open to requests from our members for future classes, so that if they want to send in an idea for one, we can always create that down the road and provide that for them.
And I think that's important. Having somebody accessible, you know, like what you guys are doing, you know, I think will make all the difference, you know, because you care, you're doing it from the right place, which I think will really serve you well when it comes to, you know, if a family is like, you know, my mom really loves this song, is there any way you could do it? You know, you're getting a person that cares versus just, you know, we'll forward this on to somebody and we'll see if they decide to do it or not. I think that's tremendous. Have you gotten any strange requests?
Well, we're still pretty small in our membership, so we haven't gotten too many requests. I've sent it out to our members, like, you know, if anything ever comes up, let us know. And I did want to mention my business partner in this is my husband. He's a professional videographer, so he does the filming side of it, and we're a small team, so we can pivot easily, and that's a plus. We film right in our home, and it's just a homey type setting, and he does all the behind the scenes type stuff. So
it's terrific. Very personable.
Yes.
Yeah. And I think, you know, we always say we're a family-owned business also, and I think there's a lot to be said for a more personable approach where you know, you're getting somebody that has really the right motives for what they're doing, you know, and I think it comes across in, you know, your last interview. I know we had just gotten just an influx of comments about people wanting to know about music therapy because you recently got your master's in music therapy, correct?
Not quite, but so that's an honor to be told that. But so I do have a professional certification in music therapy, and that's the background and experience that I pull from in these videos is 8 years of experience working in person, providing music therapy. So how the certification works is I went to school for music therapy. It's a minimum entry-level bachelor's degree. And then I did a 6-month full-time internship. And then I met all the qualifications to take the board certification exam.
Board certified music therapist. That's okay.
Yeah. And then every 5 years we recertify and we're required to get 100 continuing ed requirements in that time. So I just keep up with all of that. And I, so COVID really disrupted a lot of things, my business especially. And, but my calling has always been to make a difference using music. So this program has been just another way to continue that, to continue impacting older adults' lives and quality of life really through the use of music. And I really take my previous experience and try to just put it into these videos, the way I interact with the camera. And I'm every filming I go into, it's like they're here right with me, and I'm interacting with the camera like they're right there with me, and really encouraging them to join in singing with me. And okay, now we're going to do these stretches and exercises and that kind of thing.
So that leads me into my next question. We talked about this last time, but maybe somebody who didn't hear or see your last time with us, somebody watching right now, and they say, well, why couldn't I just go to YouTube and Google, you know, this little light of mine and play it for my mom? What's the difference between doing that versus doing it through your courses?
Yeah, great question. Well, they certainly can go to YouTube, and I don't discourage that at all. I always encourage people to use the resources out there, that especially the ones that are free because they're easily accessible. But just kind of as a comparison, YouTube tends to be more of a passive listening experience, just kind of listening to music. You might have a video to watch, but it's not really encouraging you to engage in anything. So the way these videos are designed and set up is to really encourage active engagement and meaningful engagement. And it's a solid 50 to 60 minutes of that. And then they're also tapping into me as a certified music therapist leading this through the video. And then also the quality of it, you never know what type of quality you're going to get on YouTube or what video you click, what it's going to be, that type of thing. Even the filming quality, we use professional filming equipment and professional videographer does the editing, and we pay for the subtitles to be added in of the song lyrics, and they're in large font so that it's easy for participants to engage with it.
Okay. So walk me through, and I do want to mention you guys were kind enough to give us a full demonstration. I think it's about a 20-minute demonstration that we are going to play an insert here at the end of your interview with us so that viewers and listeners can get a real full appreciation and experience of what one of these courses would be like. But what would you say, I joined your course and I'm looking for a category for my parents, and I find it and I find the song that they like. Once I hit play on that course, what happens after that? Because, you know, 50 to 60 minutes is a lot longer than what the song is, obviously. So walk us through kind of what an experience would be like.
Yeah, actually, before I walk you through, I'm glad you asked about that, because I totally forgot we're also working on building up an individual song library. So we currently have 15 songs, but our goal is to get it to 200 plus songs, and they can go into that like section of the member area and just find individual songs that really resonate with their loved one or care home residents. Yeah, so there's that. And then as far as the full length video classes, they are 50 to 60 minutes. So the flow of it usually follows the same kind of flow of activities. And I begin with a greeting song, and it's always the same one. So we, and this is something I learned in while I was in school for music therapy, is you really want to connect with your participants and kind of create this ritual of like greeting each other through song. So always start off with the same song, and that's how the video class begins. And then we do a section of singing, maybe five or six songs. And then about halfway through, we pause, give our voices a rest, and we do 5 to 10 minutes of light stretching, always in a seated position, movement to music. So getting the arms going, getting the legs going, whether it's stomping to the beat of a song, stretching the arms up and down to the rhythm. I guide them through that. So there's the movement exercise type section, pretty short out of the full length. And then we do some more singing, another 5 to 6 songs. And then we end with 5 or so minutes of deep breathing exercises and relaxation. Sometimes I guide them through the mental, emotional side of just pausing and thinking about something they're thankful for, a past memory to just dwell on and appreciate, that type of thing. And then we end with a goodbye song and sing. We always end with the same song as well to just bookend the session.
Sure. So, and that's kind of where I was going with that. This is much more than just listening to a song that has a special meaning. You're engaging their physical well-being, their cognitive well-being, and even you could say their respiratory well-being, you know, through the breathing techniques, the breathing exercises, the stretching of muscles, you know, the stomping of the feet. But then also the cognitive portion where, you know, you're engaging them to think about happy thoughts, and then also engaging their cognitive abilities with singing the songs, you know, so it's much more than just listening to a song that you enjoy, which, you know, medically has been shown to be very, very therapeutic, especially with people with cognitive decline or cognitive issues. And you also do all of the performing, correct?
Yes, it's me singing and me playing guitar. And I always say it's dementia friendly. So another way it can be used, if a home individual or care community has like small percussion instruments on hand, they can pull those out during this class and add another element of playing an instrument along with the singing portion of it.
That's great. Is this something that you could share kind of what the price is like for families that are interested?
Absolutely. It's $100 a month. And we do offer a free trial before anyone ever signs up and gives us money. Like we want them to try it and make sure it's a good fit. So yeah, that's something we're really happy to provide is a free trial.
Is it a month to month, Alexis, or is it a contract for a certain amount of time, or?
It's month to month. So cancel anytime. You're not locked into anything. You're not signing a contract for a specific length of time. It's a subscription type of service.
Okay. And then, I know before you were mentioning families can still use your services as a one-on-one therapy. Are you still going to be offering that along with your services with the senior communities?
Yeah, right now on a very limited basis, I'm able to do that because we are putting so much into this program right now, getting it off the ground.
Well, and I imagine too, I know at least in our area, the COVID situation is kind of a day-to-day thing where some facilities are not allowing other services to come in and, you know, different things like that. Healthcare providers and services are exempt from that for the most part. But then you have the gathering of groups of the residents that they're not allowed to have. So that might present an issue as well. That's fantastic. So this is on your website, correct? The Bridgetown?
It is, yes. Easily accessible on our website.
Great. What? Where do you see it in a year from now?
Well, our plan is to continue it and just really focus on connecting with the individuals and communities who it can be most beneficial to. It can be used in a lot of different ways. So, and it is, it does work with any type of COVID restrictions because a community could use it and have a caregiver going to individuals. I had one memory care facility using it and the life enrichment director was going resident to resident and using it like 20 times in a week. So they were really getting a lot of value and use out of it.
Right. When, for people watching or listening, you mentioned the free trial. Is that easily accessible on the website or is there a direct link that we could post here in the show for that? Or
yeah, there's a direct link as well as our website. It's very clear on the website.
That's exciting. Well, I really support what you and your husband are doing. I think it's terrific. I know, you know, we've seen a couple of your videos and you guys are doing great work. And I know how important it is for families to have this therapy. Music is the one thing that anyone with dementia can be benefited from. You know, it's just an interesting thing where, you know, you can have somebody who has advanced dementia, late stage dementia, but yet you play a song from their childhood or, you know, back when they were in their younger years and they can recite the words to it. You know, it's just one of those things. And it's because, and do you know the reason for that?
Well, it's tied to memories and how music imprints itself on the brain with that memory. Like it's so tightly connected.
And that's the one, yeah, the music memory is stored in a different area of the brain than our regular memories are. And that's one of the very last areas to be touched by dementia. And it's fascinating, you know. Seen so many families who, you know, they'll say, well, my mom doesn't remember us and doesn't remember her husband or, you know, all these very sad things. But yet you turn on a song that she used to sing when she was younger or that she enjoyed and she can remember lyric for lyric. And it's just, you know, it's almost bittersweet, you know. You're happy they can remember that and enjoy that, but yet at the same time, you're almost upset because, well, why can you remember that, but you can't remember these other things, you know? But it is very therapeutic and it is also mood enhancing, right? You know, you get somebody into a good mood by playing music that is uplifting and that they enjoy. Like the song you demonstrated the last time we were here, you know, you don't even have to have dementia or a health issue to have your mood enhanced by, you know, by music. So I really appreciate everything you guys are doing. And, you know, we're here to support Bridgetown Music Therapy and do whatever we can to help you guys out. And we'll have the demonstration play here at the end of the interview. And hopefully, you know, we'll be able to reach some families with it.
Yeah, thank you so much. One more thing I wanted to mention.
Yeah, absolutely.
We're working on building out our YouTube channel a little more. And I've been uploading some individual songs so you can really get an idea of what it's like in these videos. And then just some short, like 2 or 3 minute videos, kind of like a series almost, just answering questions like, how can music benefit someone with dementia? And what types of musical instruments work well with seniors? Those type of questions we're answering.
Okay, and we'll put the link in the show notes and in the YouTube description for you. And I'll leave you with one last question. What is the one biggest misconception you think there is about music therapy?
That's a great question. I think people don't always understand how much training we have been through to do what we do, and that the music therapists out there are very passionate about what they do because it's such a big commitment to become a music therapist. And it's really rewarding work, but also very tiring because it is physical, mental, emotional, and social. Like, it touches on all of the areas of functioning, and just how music therapy can be used in so many different ways to affect change and make a difference.
And you guys are making a difference, and we appreciate and thank you guys for that.
Thank you for helping us get the word out.
Absolutely. It's our pleasure, and hopefully we'll see you again here on All Home Care Matters.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us today on All Home Care Matters. All Home Care Matters is here to help families as they navigate these long-term care issues. We'd also, again, like to say thank you to Bridgetown Music Therapy and Alexis Baker for taking time out to share with us about their new online music therapy courses that they'll be offering families. If you'd like to learn more about the Bridgetown Music Therapy online courses, stay tuned because we are providing you with a short demonstration that will be starting now.
Hey there! My name is Alexis, and I'm so glad you're joining me today for this time of music. We're going to have a great time. We'll begin by singing a song together called Come Sing a Song with Me. The words will be on the screen about right here, so you can follow along and join in singing with me, okay? Come sing a song.
Share a rose with me. thank you for singing that song with me. Let's keep singing, okay? Here's a song that you might be familiar with. It's called Hey Good Lookin'. This is a song from the 50s by Hank Williams, okay? Will you sing with me? All right. Say hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me?
Phrases in that song that were familiar to you? How about Hot Rod Ford or a $2 bill? I love it. Okay, well, our next song we're gonna sing together is called, actually, let's see if you can complete the title. 5'2", Eyes of Blue, yep. Okay, here we go. 5'2", eyes of blue. But oh, what those 5 feet could do. Has anybody seen my gal? Turned up nose, turned down hose. Never had no other foes. Has anybody seen my gal? Now if you run into a 5'2" covered with fur, diamond rings and all those things, you bet your life it isn't her. Could she love, could she woo, could she, could she, could she woo? Has anybody seen my gal? All right, we're gonna try something different this time through. Pick a syllable such as la or da or do, and we're gonna sing through the melody on a syllable, okay? Da 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 da. Has anybody seen my gal? Now
got a couple more songs to sing. Here's one that I'm sure you'll recognize. It's a very well-known, well-loved, popular song, no matter your age. You are my sunshine. One more song in just a little bit, but before that, we're going to do a little bit of stretching and movement together, okay? We're gonna get our bodies going and moving to some music. So for this time, you'll want to get into a comfortable seated position. Wherever you are, just sit upright if you're able to. And if possible, place your feet flat on the ground. And we're going to get into a good posture also. So roll those shoulders back, tilt your head up, feet flat on the floor. Let's take a big, deep breath. Good. And then just to get our bodies ready, give your shoulders a shake. Yeah, loosen things up, shake those shoulders, and then shake your hands. Kind of feels good. Okay, and just as a reminder, we always, always want to avoid any pain, strain, or injury, okay? So you know your body best. I encourage you to push yourself, but not if it leads to any pain or injury, okay? Here we go. The song we're going to be moving to today is called You Gotta Sing When the Spirit Says Sing. Let me teach it to you first, and then after that, all you gotta do is watch me and follow me for the stretches and movements we'll be doing. Here's how it goes. You gotta sing when the Spirit says sing. You gotta sing when the Spirit says sing. When the Spirit says sing, you gotta sing right along. You gotta sing when the Spirit says sing and sing. Let's start with some rhythm by clapping our hands. You gotta clap when the Spirit says clap. You gotta clap when the Spirit says clap. When the Spirit says clap, you gotta clap right along. You gotta clap when the Spirit says clap. And clap and stomp your feet with me. You gotta stomp when the Spirit says stomp. You gotta stomp when the spirit says stomp. When the spirit says stomp, you gotta stomp right along. You gotta stomp when the spirit says stomp. And stomp and stretch your arms with me up and down. You gotta stretch when the spirit says stretch. You gotta stretch when the spirit says stretch. When the spirit says stretch, you gotta stretch right along. You gotta stretch when the spirit says stretch. And stretch. And keep your arms up above your head. We're gonna do a wave. You gotta wave when the spirit says wave. You gotta wave when the spirit says wave. When the spirit says wave, you gotta wave right along. You gotta wave when the spirit says wave. And wave and wave. Back to the lower body with a kick. Alternating legs. You gotta kick when the spirit says kick. You gotta kick when the spirit says kick. When the spirit says kick, you gotta kick right along. You gotta kick when the spirit says kick. And kick and kick. How about a march? You gotta march when the spirit says march. You gotta march when the spirit says march. When the spirit says march, you gotta march right along. You gotta march when the spirit says march. And march and twist with me like this. You gotta twist when the spirit says twist. You gotta twist when the spirit says twist. When the spirit says twist, you gotta twist right along. You gotta twist when the spirit says twist. And twist and roll your arms with me. You're doing great. You gotta roll when the spirit says roll. You gotta roll when the spirit says roll. When the spirit says roll, you gotta roll right along. You gotta roll when the spirit says roll. And roll. Let's end with some rhythm again. You gotta pat when the spirit says pat. You gotta pat when the spirit says pat. When the spirit says pat, you gotta pat right along. You gotta pat when the spirit says pat. And pat and clap your hands with me. You gotta clap when the spirit says clap. You gotta clap when the spirit says clap. When the spirit says clap, you gotta clap right along. You gotta clap when the spirit says clap. All right, we did it. Nice job. All right, well now we're going to focus on some deep breathing. So stay in that comfortable seated position. And put a hand or two over your belly. We're going to feel our diaphragm working. This is called belly breathing or deep breathing. It's very intentional and focused breathing. And so hand over your belly, deep breath in with me. And then hold for a second and let it out. So with belly breathing, you should feel your stomach go in and out with the exhale and inhale. Okay, let's try it again. Deep breath in, belly out, and then deep breath out. Belly in. And if it helps, you can close your eyes to shut out any distractions and really focus in on the breath. And another thing that helps me is to breathe in through my nose and out through my mouth. And then also try to take as much air in as you can and let as much air out as you can. Let's try it a couple more times together. Deep breath in. And out. Good. And this time through, let's focus on a couple of words. So as you're breathing in, think about the word cleansing. And as you're breathing out, think about the word effortless, okay? Here we go. Cleansing breath in. And effortless breath out. Good. And hopefully you're starting to feel a difference in your body. Deep breathing really helps with all kinds of things in the body. It helps release stress and anxiety. It helps release tension from the body. It helps improve mental focus and concentration. It can even help improve sleep. It can give your energy levels a boost, all kinds of things. So, not to mention it helps get more oxygen to the brain, which helps with all kinds of functions in the body, such as lowering heart rate and blood pressure. So that's why we do these deep breathing exercises. Now I'm going to sing through a song and we'll do a little more deep breathing. The words will prompt you, okay? Breathing in, breathing out, that's what life is all about. Breathing in, breathing out, that's what life is all about. Feel free to close your eyes if that's helpful. One more time through. Breathing in, breathing out, that's what life is all about. Breathing in, breathing out, that's what life is all about. Beautiful. Alright, if your eyes were closed, you can now open them. And let's do two more deep breaths together. Here we go. Deep breath in. And deep breath out. And deep breath in. And let it out. Great. I hope you're feeling better after that. And thank you for joining me for music today. We're going to sing one last song to say goodbye. This song is called Happy Trails. The words will be on the screen about right here, so you can follow along and join in singing with me. Okay, here we go. For joining me today, and just like that song says, keep smiling. Bye bye.
Thank you for joining us today. We look forward to you joining us again on another episode of All Home Care Matters. To learn more about the show and to connect with us, visit us at allhomecarematters.com.